Do you want to learn how to create and manipulate vectors and matrices in MATLAB, the most popular software for scientific computing? Hi, I'm Ankit, and welcome to NucleuX, the channel where I teach you how to use MATLAB for various applications. In this video, I'll show you how to do it in just 7 minutes. So grab your laptop and get ready to learn something new and exciting. So, what exactly are vectors and matrices? Vectors and matrices are collections of numbers arranged in rows and columns. A vector is a one-dimensional array of numbers, while a matrix is a two-dimensional array of numbers. For example, this is a vector with 3 elements. And this is a matrix with 3 rows and 3 columns. You can think of vectors and matrices as containers that hold numerical data. You can use them to represent various quantities and concepts, such as coordinates, forces, velocities, signals, images, equations, etc. First of all, let me show you how to make vectors in MATLAB. There are many ways to do it, but here are some of the easiest ones. 1. Using square brackets. You can use square bracket to make vectors by putting the numbers inside the brackets. You can use commas or spaces to separate the numbers. For a row vector, you can put the numbers in one row. For a column vector, you can put the numbers in one column. For example, to make a row vector with 4 numbers, you can type A equals 1, 2, 3, 4, having space between them. Press Enter, and here is row vector. To make a column vector with 4 numbers, you can type B equals 1, semicolon, 2, semicolon, 3, semicolon, 4, and hit Enter, it'll create column vector. Method 2. There is another way to make vectors, which is using colon operator. You can use the colon operator to make vectors with numbers that are evenly spaced. The colon operator has the following syntax. Start, colon, step, colon, end. Where start is the first number of the vector, step is the difference between the numbers, and end is the last number of the vector. If you don't write the step value, MATLAB thinks it is 1. For example, to make a row vector with 5 numbers from 1 to 5 with a difference of 1, you can type C equals 1 colon 5. It gives row vector C having 1 to 5 number. To make a row vector with number between 0 to 15 with a difference of 2, you can type D equals 0 colon 2 colon 15. It creates row vector D. To make a column vector with 6 numbers from minus 3 to 0, with a difference of 1, you can type E equals minus 3 colon 2, transpose. Note that we have used the transpose operator to change the row vector into a column vector. Third method to create vector is by using linspace function. You can use the linspace function to create vectors with evenly spaced elements. The linspace function has the syntax linspace start, comma, end, comma, n. Where start is the first element of the vector, end is the last element of the vector, and n is the number of elements in the vector. For example, to create a row vector with 5 elements from minus 2 to 2, you can type F equals linspace minus 2, comma, 2, comma, 5. You get a row vector having dimension 1 cross 5, which means 1 row and 5 columns. To create a column vector with 6 elements from pi to pi, you can type G equals linspace minus pi, pi, 6, transpose. Hit Enter, and you will get column vector of order 6 cross 1, which means 5 rows and 1 column. Now, you have learned how to make vectors. Let's see how to make matrices. A matrix is like a table of numbers. Each row has the same number of items. Each column has the same number of items too. You can use spaces or commas to separate the numbers in a row. You can use semicolons to separate the rows. For example, look at this matrix. Mat equals 231, semicolon, 465. It has 2 rows and 3 columns. You can separate rows in matrix by hitting the Enter key after each row instead of typing semicolon when entering the values. Note that you can't make a matrix with different numbers of values in each row or column. That will give you an error message. For example, if you attempt to create a matrix in which there are different numbers of values in the rows, the result will be an error message. We can also use the transpose operator to flip the rows and columns of a vector or matrix. For example, to create a 3x2 matrix with the same numbers as before. TAM equals 1, 2, 3, semicolon, 4, 5, 6. And you get transpose matrix. You can also make some special matrices with built-in functions. One of them is rand. It makes matrices with random numbers. If you give rand one number x, it makes a square matrix with x rows and x columns. For example, if you give 3, it creates square matrix of order 3. If you give rand two numbers x and y, it makes a matrix with x rows and y columns. For example, if you give 4 and 5, it creates a 4x5 matrix. This is called rectangle matrix. The rand function makes matrices with decimal numbers. If you want to make matrices with integers only, you can use randi function instead. It makes random matrices with integers. The zeros function creates a matrix of all zeros, and the ones function creates a matrix of ones. Like rand function, either one argument can be passed, which creates square matrix, or two arguments, which creates rectangle matrix. You can use the I function to create identity matrices filled with ones on the main diagonal and zeros elsewhere. The I function has the syntax IN, where N is the size of the square matrix. For example, to create an identity matrix of size 3, we pass argument as 3. Now that you have a basic understanding of how to create vectors and matrices in MATLAB, it's time to get creative and experiment with different sizes and values. And if you want to learn more about performing various operations on vectors and matrices, be sure to tune into our next video. And before you go, here's a question for you. How can you create a diagonal matrix with the elements 1, 2, 3, 4 in MATLAB? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to NucleuX for more exciting programming tutorials. See you at next video. Till then, bye.